welcome to the Gilded Vessel. In your problems, it said we are anchored off an island. But due to security reasons, we are now drifting 6 miles south of Monte Carlo. My name is Detective Inspector Ivan Blue. To my closest friend, I'm called simply Ivan. Or if you live in a massacre, be evil. I have been on board this ship for the last few days disguised as a wine maker. Couldn't see much. To investigate counterfeit champagne, which has been smuggled aboard this yacht. This is on the strict instructions of the master of this vessel, Archibald Barrington Frapp. But alas, I have bad news for you, ladies and gentlemen. At approximately 5:15 p.m. this afternoon, I found the body of my dear friend, who had been stabbed with an elegant weapon. And everyone on board this ship is a suspect. Due to the complexity of this case, I'm afraid I might ask for your assistance in finding the killer. But beware, in doing so, that you don't implicate yourselves at the same time. I did some notes when I found the body earlier today, and these I will read out to you now. If you'd like to take notes, please do so, because there might be also unacceptable assistance in the end.
This was found in the victim's body. Also, a small
charge that was found in the top pocket of the victim. These are two pieces of evidence which I keep in a plastic bag so that we don't have any fingerprints on them, so that when we get back from Monte Carlo, I can have these verified fingerprints verified. Also, an open bottle of liqueur near, and also nearby, a liqueur glass with bearing the scent of bitter almonds. Those are the main clues at the moment. The main suspects, as you can gather, are sitting up there. And I would like your assistance in doing so from time to time. The theory. If it bears that class in this is without the death of drugs, I have been chasing off without cure or burial. Could you enlighten us, please?
How can you say this, Archibald, but my very great friend? I am surprised that you could even suggest that one of us killed him. Does anybody here know anything that might shed some light on this?
No. Yes, I can tell you something, Detective. I was on the ship earlier today, and I saw you, Mal, walking along the corridor with your tool in your hand.
I'll have you know, m'lady, that I am the captain of this ship, and I can walk on anywhere I like. I often walk around with my tool in my hand. In fact, the way it looks like better wear must have been a trick of the light. I often walk around. I have to do minor repairs when my engineer is ashore.
It's very suspicious, I think, Mal. Very suspicious.
He was not sorted at all. We were very much in love. I enjoyed it and saw the chief.
Yeah.
And now you say you are a trustee? So much a trustee, in fact, that when she falls into the debt and worries about money, who does she turn to? You, her trustee? Or Archibald Pratt? It was Archibald she turned to, was it not, was it?
Yeah, I'm afraid that is true.
And what happened to give him because of that? What did you have to give him in return?
Ooh, what?
No one's actually given to me. She gave that to me, I am. What did you have to give to him? In return.
Well, I am afraid that I had to give him the juicy dagger, the word murder weapon. And
yes,
I
yes, ma'am.
Champagne. He had a letter some weeks ago saying that a friend of his in England had brought some champagne and it was terrible. And then some days ago on the boat, man will remember when we had dinner, the champagne was terrible. Now you are in charge of the champagne.
Let's
know something about this.
That was a job for the chief steward. It was nothing to do with me at all, my dear. He used to look after the wines and spirits, in the general, big stalling of the ship.
But you have the overall management. You are the one that has access to the champagne.
I am not the only one that has access to certain parts of the ship. You also had access to Paul Larchie's cabin.
Uh-huh.
I was told by the door that only you and myself and perhaps the chief engineer knew about. Am I correct? There was another door, am I correct? And you used to use it, did you not?
No. There was a door that connected from my cabin into Archibald's cabin, but I never used it. I used to keep the
water open to the closet. Well, the only thing that I heard you used to use to attract Archibald that used to put me on your ears, your name is wrong.
Somebody that that belongs to the platter set.
And she was, you are always there.
I have not succumbed to him, you may be sure. But others have, beginning a few years ago with a poor Italian opera singer. Even now he seeks a new conquest and virtually has the Gutierrez on a string. Of this I will not say more, for it is too desperate to set to paper. But have hope and say a prayer for me. We depart on a week's cruise this, and there's no more. What is his name, dearie? Tell us.
I will admit that I hated him. He ruined my family. My poor father died after the vineyard opening. I have to raise my six brothers and sisters. I will tell you that my plan was a financial one. I would not have killed you.
About what I'm doing with my troop. I've told her I'm the captain of this ship. I have to look out for
you. What you are doing with work is in your back pocket. Come up with an answer for that.
I was using it to change a plug in Paul Martin's cabin.
Does anybody believe that?
No.
They haven't discovered electricity yet, or what?
It's a diesel-driven yacht, not a sailboat, I'll have you know. And don't forget, I'm a bloody war hero, and I've got medals to prove it. I don't remember what my dress uniform was.
Inspector, I just remembered something. As you know, I travel extensively through Europe with my jewelry trade. I have heard that members of the Russian Bolsheviks have been looking and searching ruthlessly across Europe for the Tsarine's jewels, and because they could not find Ruth, they thought maybe Nadia was guilty. And particularly the current Detroit, because they think that she has it, and in fact, if she does not come out with it, they have threatened her very existence.
Sir, that is true. I had an escape from Russia. It was terrible there, Derek. I borrowed some of the Tsar's jewels, and I managed to reach Nadia. I sold the tiara to Archie. And with the money, I opened my nightclub. Now the Russian Bolsheviks are after me, and Archie will not sell me back the tiara. If I do not put the tiara back and with the Russian Bolsheviks, they will kill me. I am desperate.
I hear it was not just tonight that she opened, Inspector. She opened something else as well.
No, that is not true. He will not let me have the tiara.
Inspector, are you listening to me?
I am.
You have to know something about Bellingham. She has not always been a famous opera singer. I remember some years ago, I was learning this opera, this minor opera in Italy. It was called The Unkindest Cut of All. It was about a man who was castrated in battle.
I am talented, so what? lot of people, especially men.
That was actually very interesting to hear it, because on Archie's door, they've got this lock, hasn't he? It's voice activated.
Yes, now I can catch that. Perhaps I can illuminate all of you.
Voice activated.
Perhaps I can illuminate all of you, even the people down in the flat might have caller. Perhaps I can illuminate all of you, that I'm certain that this lady, with her tremendous range of voice, could even impersonate Paul Archie's voice. Your range of voice was that good, my dear. I'm certain that if you wanted to, you could use your voice to get into the room. Am I correct?
What a load of rubbish. I have a good range, but I am not a mimic. It is a different thing altogether, man. Just because I keep talking about your tool, there is no need to get back at me.
Mind you, you did show interest in the lot, didn't you?
So yes, you're a great amount of interest. As my chief engineer at Balkwill. And I don't mind if I have another large one.
I don't remember this, but all you said.
Inspector, in an attempt to deflect any idea that I was guilty, I was not, because Archibald was a friend of mine. I think there is something you should know.
Be quiet, I'm speaking.
I think there is something you should know. This pompous English middle class player with his fox
upper.
A life insurance policy for $1 million.
What?
Shall I tell you on whose life it is? Or shall we ask him to tell you on whose life it is?
Whose life?
Tell them, my friend Clayton.
All right. I do have an insurance policy on poor old
Archie. I do, Inspector.
I must say, you wouldn't understand, being foreigners. In business, you have to do these things to protect your investment. Sure, do you, don't you?
Yes!
What you do with it? You have to protect yourself. I've nothing more to do with you. $1 million, I wouldn't touch it.
What are you taking to look like that? So you would have to give me to dream at you.
I trust this information will be
you. There is a further letter saying, I have now determined to my satisfaction the names and identities of my children, as set forth to you in a previous wire. This letter will instruct you immediately to prepare a change in my will, leaving one half of my estate, one to Myers and one to Bear.
Ah, that's the same names you two have got.
This proves that they are brother and sister, and heirs to Archie's fortune. They are the strong teeth of living, sir man.
Yeah, he's not acting working at all, but I do recall Bella, my sister. As a child, she had a very clever ability to imitate friends' abilities.
Oh, you said you could not imitate.
He was my father. I would not kill him.
No,
no. But that's something you have to bear with good motives.
Not
a very
good motive. Do not accuse me of killing my father. How can you say that?
But you did not
shout at me.
How
can you have a few
seconds
to think about it? One hour give. Go fight. I'll give a brief resume of just what happened there, because they are, as I said before, they might be my little children. If I come up this end, it's all not right. You know, we can't hear. It is very, very minimal. So I will stand up to this morning out of the way, if I may. I've written a few notes which might be of interest to you anyhow. Lucy, she's up to her debt, her neck, up to here, in debt. She goes to the casino, gambles like mad, and also is on seen out with businessmen in the town as well. Desiree, a few minutes ago you were crying buckets. So now she calls Trapp a lecher and she wants him dead. What a change in her husband. Can this never see? Lecturer. What a combo. There you see. Pound with his hand on the till again. He has a lie. Thank you.
chatting to his refrigeration engineer, the chief engineer, asking about the refrigeration unit and air intakes and all the water intakes. What the hell was that then?
This is very simple. As a child, I was sent away to France with Michel and Pierre Latour, and I had a refrigeration engineer in business. Of course, I might have an active interest in this. But this reminds me, on the way back from Monte Carlo, I heard you and Pratt having an argument. Pratt was very, very angry at you, and you were very, very flush. I did not hear all that was said, but I did hear Pratt say to you that he nearly bankrupted the Lucy estate and he did not want you doing the same to his.
Out of it, old boy, but I do resent the fact that you foreigners keep calling on us British and accuse us of things we've never done. Rather bad form, don't you know?
Look,
you know, I'm a cruiser-driven stir. Slush. There's all these suspicious circumstances going on. Now, take our bell again. I was outside, or I was inside my cabin earlier on, and I heard a voice say, "Open in the name of Frat." And now that's how the lock opens, you see. Open in the name of Frat. And when I looked up, who should I see but Bella? And I had you explain that.
By telling you that I was walking down the corridor and I saw the door open.
Quietly.
I went inside and I noticed the safe was locked. My father's diary was on his desk and I read one of the pages. This is what it said. I will read it with an English accent. The memoirs of Archibald Pratt. Are you all listening?
Yeah.
Everyone's listening.
Yes.
An English accent in the middle of a month, all right. Being an account of the adventures of a most extraordinary individual, namely myself, Archibald Bennington Frank. While this work began with no more elaborate a title than to set forth above, I have, due to the nature of the exploits described within, decided to append a subtitle which I deem altogether appropriate. Is no more, therefore, memoirs of Archibald Frank, but the rapes of Frank. In September 1900, the entry is as follows. I have always dominated the women in my life. No exception was the first woman I seduced, one Silvia Rigolotto, a comely Italian singer. I was at the time no more than 22 years of age, and passion ran within me like fire through a dry brush. I believe I gave Sylvia a child or two. I hardly know or care. June 1910. On my travels, I made it a point to experience local womanhood, much as one might seek out a local wine, savour it for its own distinctive qualities rather than its refinement. In this way, in Russia, St. Petersburg, in fact, I met a pretty young dancer whom I took to be Russian. She was not, it turned out, but American. Her name, as I recall it, was Ruby Rhinestone, or some such vulgarity. A stage name, to be sure, for she travelled with a troupe of chorus girls. I myself travelled incognito, using the name John Smith. After Ruby, I sought out, by way of contrast, a woman of quality and breeding, such as one might return to a wine of noble vintage after sampling the more common varieties. This is what I found. It is very interesting.
Can I have that letter, please?
Certainly, detective.
Yes, Inspector. What? Why do you to restrain me? I want to tell the Inspector what I know. Because
I know something about you that I think is German and late.
Well, I am a great lover, you mean?
No. Do not believe it.
Well, you never complain.
That is
too much of a lady.
Exhibit here in your top hat. Found where, detective? Where is it found?
I found it in the victim's top jacket.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have seen this somewhere before. It's the apartment of you.
an international jeweller to have a look and see whether in fact she went in. So I found myself in her apartment one night when she was out on one of their sordid affairs. And I found inside her apartment proof that in fact her name is not Nadia at all, but her name is Ruby. A dealer in cheap counterfeit jewels. Ruby, the rhinestone cowboy. Is this not true? Ruby, would the real Ruby, I wonder, stand up and tell us who she is and what about us? You bitch.
Oh, she, you found out my secret. When we got to Russia with no money, I survived by singing and dancing. It just happened that at this time I met Archie when he was in Russia. We had a little affair. It's very lucky that I was employed at the Tsar's palace. Well, when I managed to escape from there, I stole some of the Tsar's jewels. I thought I was entitled, I had no money. But when I arrived in Paris, I had to sell the tiara so that I could get some money to open my nightclub, and that's all there was to it. So there, I
knew that Russian accent was a phony.
I'm not surprised. I've got to say, again, Detective, you do not seem to be listening to me and hearing what I say.
I saw
you coming out of Archie's cabin. Again, I say it. I think to see a lot of people.
I also saw you, Marley. You might have known something like a pair of wires. What on earth were you doing with them?
I have to repair.
Could you, Captain Mark, could you stand there? I have to leave the residue.
I have to repair one or two minor electrical codes. One or two minor electrical
codes.
Problems with electricity in four miles of cabin. And that's the entire story of why I was in Paul Larch's cabin, not rest assured, sorting out one or two minor electrical problems.
You are the captain of the ship, you can command anybody to do this for you. Why were you...
Half the crew were ashore. And the other half, well, they wouldn't have got where. I wouldn't have allowed them to be on the ship that I was while I was serving in the Royal Navy.
Do you keep telling us about you being a war hero? But I know that you were drunk in charge of the warship that you were in, and it ran aground on a reef. And it was only by a free high tide that took you off the reef. And you accidentally sunk that German ship, and that was what your medal was for, is worthless. Anyway, what happened to all that champagne that was on board? I heard all about that and it's never been found. That's very suspicious.
It went to the Davy Jones's locker, my dear.
No, your ship was brought home. You brought your ship home. It's the Russian ship that was sunk.
Are you listening to this inspector, detective? I seem to be the only person here who has any knowledge of any of these very important activities. Was it not me who noticed the baton missing from Val's jacket? Was it not me who noticed the top hat?
Yes.
I noticed in Jules' apartment. And Detective Pestle.
What about this?
May I ship him the blame on everyone else?
And you have checked the
I'm
going to
concerned that you were spying on him. What do you have to say to that?
Yeah, I think of that man, she did not spy. You have a fact, have you? You are a guilty man. You do not know what you are talking about.
No, and I must say, Lucy, you are very good at spotting the gold button and the top hat. But another page in my father's diary. And remember the word vividly. Am I right? Vividly. Are you listening, everyone? Everyone, are you listening? The words are imprinted on my brain. Lucy, and I quote my father's words, Lucy came to me with the deadly goosey dagger as I commanded her. She was reluctant to surrender it, and when I insisted, she became enraged and attempted to stab me with it, succeeding in cutting deeply into my shoulder. I had to overpower her to prevent further damage. She showed scant appreciation for my generosity in paying off her debts. I say to you, Lucy, if you did it once, perhaps you did it twice, it is early!
My father told me from when I was a little boy, I forgot my numerals. This afternoon, I took a boat to go fishing. My dad taught me to fish since I was a little girl. And I cast a rope with a hook on the end and it opened to the porthole. Is this in the song?
No.
I was surprised to see that the safe was already open, so I snatched the tea out there. I noticed some blood on the floor and a sheath from a dagger, but I had no time to think about this. No time to think about this.
Back to Monte Carlo,
I think you're
the Can you tell me what you've got to do?
not killed his father.
Of course I will not kill my father.
But let us remember, you should be taken to the afterlife. I remember. 1 minute he is a refrigeration machine. The next minute he is a locomotive. And the next minute he is winning car races in Monte Carlo. Where does the money come from? And to what use now? To what use now, Inspector, does he put his skill as a refrigerator mechanic?
Why follow the mistress each other? I have told you and everybody it is Lucy.
Yes. Protect your brother. Protect your brother.
Is it not Lucy?
No.
Yes. Have a bit of it. Stop it. Pour out.